poems of the same author, you know, that bring out various nuances of that one author. Like if you're talking of frost, you're looking at a mending wall, you're looking at a wood, you're looking at the woods, you're looking at, you know, two tramps coming out of the mud. So one is exposing them to the same author in different ways, and then poems that have the same kind of rhythm or sound, that, and of course pieces of music sometimes that, you know, bring out the same emotion or the same rhythm. You know, it could be something as basic as the same rhythm, a similar rhythm or a style, or it could be an emotion that they need to be helped to find in a piece of music also. And the relationship that comes out of that poem and music, right? So that helps sometimes. And of course there are some who don't appreciate music, but as I told you, it's a larger group that you're dealing with, and they very often feel compelled. And so these things, when we listen to a piece of music, sometimes that touches them. And just the fact of, you know, trying to get a child to read something that's outside the text, that itself becomes challenging at times. And so when you have a child who's not much of a reader, suddenly come back to you at break time and say, "Teacher, may I look at that essay from Orwell again?" And then you feel satisfied. You feel like, okay, you made a start. Sometimes really, pictures and paintings, you know, art, has this wonderful capacity of being, you know, all interlinked. Somewhere you can find a similar emotion in a painting, and that's how I try to help people.